Hey guys, Nicole Cordoves here, and we are only a week away from the finals night of Binibining Pilipinas. That is why we arranged this special shoot for all of you, because my special guest for today, ang pinakahintay nating lahat, ang bagong MGI queen, Samantha Bernardo. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So it's 7 a.m. It's gonna be an early shoot, and I planned something very, very special with the one and only Samantha Bernardo. So a lot of you were requesting the updated interview with Sam post MGI pageant. So we're gonna talk about that today. But I'll tell you a little bit first about our shoot today, because Jelly trained me how to do content. So pinaasikaso niya sa akin lahat. Like, to be fair, Jelly, sobrang hirap pala ng ginagawa niyo. As in, congrats. Yun lang. Nabinyagan ako talaga. So from the pegs and the creative direction! Yeah, I collated it in a deck, and I'll show you guys here. So the theme is the after party, para we can sort of celebrate also Sam's victory in Miss Grand International. So per peg, ano siya, parang may pageant elements. So parang first is swimsuit round, hence the snatched cut crease, and the long hair.
So our first layout, of course, full skin muna tayo, which is we're very lucky to have a custom fit boom Sason. She made it for 3 days na.
So Sam, marami nagtatanong, kamusta yung overall experience mo sa Miss Grand?
Oh my gosh, sobrang saya. As in, wala akong masabi na bad comments, wala akong masabi na parang hindi ko na-enjoy yung every moment. Kasi talagang binigay ko talaga lahat doon from the moment that I stepped in Thailand. And sobrang overwhelming din yung support. So I would like to thank everyone, the Filipino community sa Thailand. Talagang very supportive sila, because the moment that they know na mag-isa lang ako doon, never ko na-feel na mag-isa ako.
Hindi mo ba na-feel na parang mas mabait yung mga tao during your competition? Hindi, parang sobrang all-out love lang talaga. Wala akong nakitang bashing at all, yes. Kahit yung mga small details. Although hindi mo rin kasi kami binigyan ng rason.
To
say anything pa about you. Ang linis lahat.
I think people know kung ano yung pinagdaanan ko in Binibining Pilipinas. And despite the pandemic, they see the fire in me. And that's why siguro dun din nila na-appreciate na it's time for Samantha Bernardo to go there and celebrate naman in pageantry. And which, yun din talaga yung ginawa ko. Ayoko na kasi mag-isip. And I've never seen a bashing because hindi ko talaga ako nagbasa.
Kasi, tama yan.
Kasi ayoko nang ma-distract. And at the same time, hello, in the 20 days of preparation, I don't have the time and energy to put a little bit of energy to those things. So I'd rather focus on my speech, diba, on the things that matters, and that's why I am so thankful for you. Kasi talagang you are there. Even Ate Parul always messaging me, and also Elizabeth Plency, and all of the MGI queens then. Of course, Samantha Law, and of course, Eva. So they've been there in my journey, and because never ko na-feel na mag-isa ko. So thank you so much.
Siyempre. What about your expectations and reality? Parang, siyempre, meron tayong medyo napipicture sa mind natin bago tayo lumipad, di ba?
Yes.
Of what the org would be like, the, ano, did you expect na ganun kaganda yung production? Kasi, ibang level na kayo this
ibang level.
Year.
Okay, nasabi mo na yun before na talagang yung grand is really grand, wala talagang parang any bad moments, but yung expectations na yun, kasi I just visualize. And the only expectations that I can put on myself. Mm-mm. So, the way I would present myself, the way I would like to be seen, yun lang yung expectation ko. But with the organizers, parang gusto ko lang silang ma-meet lahat, makilala sila and all.
Pero sabi mo nga, hindi ka nagbabasa ng mga comments and feedback ng mga tao. Pero may expectations pa rin tayo kahit papano ng magiging reception sa atin ng mga fans.
Yes.
Naramdaman mo ba kahit papaano at least?
naramdaman ko kasi everything is online.
Mm-mm.
So every feedback na mararamdaman or mababasa ko in social media, it boosts me.
Yeah.
Kasi syempre andun pa din ako. But most importantly kasi I talk to the people behind me. So my core team. And then sila lang yung nag-a-update sa akin that you are doing great job, you are doing this. So far, wala silang nabigay na nega comments for me. And I know na hindi rin nila ako bibigyan ng nega comments kasi they know that I am an overthinker.
Yeah.
So they just boosting me through good comments and like constructive criticism. But most importantly, I think na-enjoy ko naman lahat. And nung pumunta na ako ng Miss Grand, sobrang ganda.
Yeah.
Sobrang ganda.
Naingit na ako. Sabi ko, sana this year ako lumaban. Lalo na yung haba kasi ng rampan yung
grabe,
girl. Tapos yung main flag, yun yung favorite ko.
Oh my God. Yun din. Favorite ko yun sa production. Nung nakita ko yung flag, oh my gosh. Nung nakita namin yung stage, this is it. Alam mo yung kahit 3 hours na yung tulog mo, parang wow. Ito na yun.
Gaganahan kang lumaban talaga.
And the people behind it, it's so creative, di ba? Sobrang,
I think... konti pa rin sila.
Konti pa rin. I think 7 lang. Mm-hmm. Yung nag-choreo sa amin, nag-direct, gumawa ng lights and everything. And I'm like, wow, this is really great.
Yeah. So parang medyo tumama naman tayo sa expectations.
Yes.
Pero na-surpass nila also at the same
na-surpass
time.
Na-surpass kasi di ba host country din sila.
Yeah, oo. Sarap lumaban talaga sa Thailand, di ba? Pero... ano yung moment na na-feel mo na frontrunner ako?
Nung dumating ako.
Ay, paglapag na paglapag, girl.
Kasi I know na pag dumating ako doon, yun na yun, start na. Uh-huh. Diba sinabi mo ngayon sa akin na it's just really from the beginning until the end that they will choose the winner. And sinabi din naman din yun sa akin nila, Tipa Rule, na parang wala talagang, parang, anong tawag dyan? Criteria for judging sa Miss Grand. It's really about the trend. It's really about how you present yourself, di ba? But the moment that I step in there, kasi dire-diretso kami eh.
Mm-mm.
As in, wala kami nakita. Pero I saw may camera and all, and then may mga fans na nag-aabang. So sabi ko, wow, this is like the feeling of competing in pageantry. Lahat online, konti lang yung tao, but the support that you can get there through videos, kakalat.
Yeah.
So, na-feel ko na welcome talaga ako.
Pero I'm so happy nga na sobrang lakas ng social media approach ng Miss Grand
Grabe.
This year.
I didn't expect na mag-video editing din ako.
Nakagard ka ba nun, girl?
Like... sobrang hagard. To tell you honestly, guys, sobrang hagard. Because when we were in quarantine, I have to move a bed. Kasi I am living in 2 beds eh. So I have to move the bed, tinanggal ko yung frame, tinanggal ko talaga yung
so
headboard.
So redecorate mo yung room.
Yes, para lang magkaroon ako ng space to train.
Yeah.
And of course, para din mayroon akong pang OOTD pictures.
Well, girl, talagang busog na busog kami nun sa content talaga. Tsaka feeling ko, what you did nung time na naka-quarantine ka, parang tinatrain mo sarili mo rin everyday na mag-ayos. And
totoo.
It's the best time to take risks, di ba?
Tama.
Kasi, ano eh, hindi pa siya like super official event, but at the same time, you produce content.
Kasi I don't know how to really curl my hair.
Yeah.
That's why...
Pero Beyonce, lagi yung hair mo, girl. Di ka marunong, pero lagi Beyonce.
Dinaanala
okay.
Sa hairspray. Dinaanala sa... Kasi lagi ina-explain ni Darwin, babe, hindi ka maganda pag may ganito sa hair, ganyan, kailangan ilabas mo talaga, ganyan. So, I know naman my strengths and weaknesses.
Yeah.
And then, nagpo-focus na lang ako lagi sa strengths ko. So, the moment that I step in there, nag-mindset talaga ako na I really need to be healthy. Physically, emotionally, and mentally. Kasi if you're alone in quarantine, and feeling ko nakatulong din yung lockdown natin ng 10 months.
Ayan.
Parang ang dali
na
lang for
na
me.
Tayo, yeah.
Parang ang dali na lang for me na, okay, it's okay. 2 weeks lang yan. 2 weeks lang yan, Sam. I always have this mindset. But there were moments in, di ba, in the room na parang, oh my God, I'm alone.
Mm-hmm.
You're always on your head. So what I did is, nanonood ako ng... Love Island, Australia. Pero pa, hindi talaga ako nakakapag-focus dun, but I just really want to hear people
noise.
Talking.
Uh-oh.
Yes. Kasi nakakabingi yung silence.
Yeah.
And parang gusto ko din at the end of the day, meron ako social interaction.
Uh-oh.
Parang nakikita ko sila, okay na ako.
Uh-oh.
Diba? Kasi wala eh. Wala talaga.
Yeah.
And binibigay lang yung food. We check our temperature every day. We practice our dance. Binisinan nila yung dance namin. Tapos ipapractice namin yung memorize namin. We always have video editing.
Yeah.
OOTD. So, training pa for walk and diba, Q&A. So, ang dami kong ginawa.
Although, and, I would like to, to compliment you talaga. Like, I wanna give you credit. Kasi,
thank you.
You could have slacked off. Sa totoo lang. Pero na-feel ko talaga, ang bihira din mag-message ni Sam and mag-feel ko na sobrang busy siya. Na-butt-dial pa niya ako habang nag-suot siya ng sapatos. Sabi ko, alam mo, ito tumatawag. Ano nangyayari?
Sorry nga. Oh my God.
So, medyo aligaga siya pero hindi ko naman na-feel na stress siya. Yeah. So, parang, I would like to commend you for that. Kasi, pwede namang magpahinga ka eh. Alam mo yun, may ganung option eh. Pero, you chose to do the, to put in the good, the hard work talaga.
I feel like growing up in a province, I have very limited opportunity. That's why if I have an opportunity to excel on such thing, I don't want it to be wasted. Kaya, the moment I step in there, I'll just always give my best. Siguro, ang difference lang ng nung Binibining Pilipinas ko with MGI is na-enjoy ko talaga siya.
Yeah.
Kasi parang I don't need to prove myself to anyone. Kasi I'm the only Miss Philippines there. Eh. Yeah. Parang they don't know me. And everyone there is just so grateful. Alam mo yun, kaya wala yung tarayan. Yeah. Wala, as in never gonna feel.
So, ang ganda nga ng spirit niyo eh. Sobra. Tapos kahit yung top 5, parang maganda yung friendship niyo.
Halata ba? Sa paghampas ko kay Amilan.
Girl! So, mapanakit talaga si Sam.
Hindi manahampas din kita dito. Pero alam mo yung feeling na alam namin na kahit sinong manalo on top 5, it's deserving.
Yeah.
Kaya sobrang happy namin ng top 5. Mm-hmm. Even Indonesia, Guatemala, and Brazil, they're all amazing. Na minsan nga nagbibiroon kami, bakit ba ako yung runner-up? Bakit ikaw yung ano? Parang gano'n. Kasi parang sobrang close na namin.
Tsaka wala talagang hard feelings or anything,
wala,
di ba?
Wala, kasi we know at the end of the day, it's still a competition. Yeah. Someone will learn from, di ba? Mm-hmm. And then someone will win.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make you less of a woman na a first runner-up tayo.
Agree.
Di ba?
Or it doesn't discount your journey as
yes.
well.
Yes. And gusto ko din i-comment ka. Kasi, wow!
Ba't ako nasabi? Contestant ka
kasi vlog mo to. Hindi, kasi parang you have proven to us that you don't need to really win the crown. In order to do something. Ah, hindi. Ituloy ko ba? O, iyak na.
Hindi ako iyak!
Hindi, parang in order to be really a queen of who you are. And we have higher respects for you. And that's why then parang for me, it's not masakit.
Mm-mm.
It's because we have queens like you to inspire us. Na true queen talaga.
We perfect ka talaga sa akin sa Q&A.
Ay, hindi ba? Ay, six. Hindi, parang, alam mo yun, nagigets mo ba yung feeling ko? Na parang, alam mo na yun. I know, alam mo naman yun, but minsan hindi mo yun naririnig, diba? Kasi we sometimes tend to think na we need recognition pa din.
Mm-hmm.
Or we need that crown
to
be something else. But we already are like that, so.
Okay! Shoot na tayo! But thank you, Sam. Thank you. Actually, because you joined Binibini 3 times. So, how did you stay motivated? Parang is it something na feeling ko kasi I can get a crown, eh, kaya I'll keep joining? Or is it something na feeling mo builds your character?
In everything that I do, I feel like I need to have a purpose. But during those times, kahit wala na akong purpose, minsan, with the help of the people that really loved me, supported me, and talagang andyan for me no matter what happens, dun talaga ako nabuboost. Kasi minsan there were times na never ko na-imagine that I can get a crown. Pero ever since, like for example, Tito Roche of Kagandahang Flores, since 2013, he believed in me. And he never gave up on me when I feel like I already gave up for myself. So, si Tito Raj talaga nag-encourage sa akin to join every year in Binibini because people don't know, first week ng Feb yung birthday niya. Tapos kakantahan niya na talaga ako, yan yung parang panghirit niya sa mga girls. Sasabihin niya, Nak, sorry, birthday gift mo na lang sa akin, sumali ka ng Binibini. Until lang nangyari, naging every year siya. It's because I still have the chance. So, yun talaga yun. I did join Binibini because of Tito Raj and Mommy G. That's why I owe it to them.
Yeah. How about the girls? Kasi I heard from the other girls na you're an ate to them. Ikaw yung, parang may club nga daw kayo, tapos ikaw yung president or something.
Oh,
like
that. As in, naalala ko noong 2019, inaasar nila ako. Ate Sam, like for example, we don't know what's gonna happen in Binibini. Tapos parang ako na yung nagbe-brief sa kanila. And then sometimes, Sir Ines and Tita Liliana will message me and then disseminate this to the girls. So parang class president talaga
yung yeah.
So yun, I think that's my purpose also. Coming in Binibini to be an inspiration also for the other girls. I mean, no organization naman is perfect. But with the help of artists like us, like yeah. you to me, di ba? It makes everything better and lighter.
Does it get easier? Like, every time you join? Mas, kasi mas kapamon na siya, alam mo na yung sistema.
To be honest, no. It gets harder. Because at the first time, I don't have expectations for myself if I win or not. Parang masaya na lang ako ng doon.
Uh-oh.
But when I did join for 2019, there's always like, I should not fail because I've done it already and I know I can make it just with the right focus. So, mas may pressure siya. And with 2020, anything can happen, so I just let go and let God. Kaya parang naalala ko with your mentoring before, that's really my video about letting go and letting God. And that's what I adopt also for MGI.
Alam mo, yeah, it's really like a mental game. Diba? Like, you need to be in the right headspace. Pero you mentioned yung mentoring sessions namin before.
Yes.
And actually, to be honest, kinabahan ako sa'yo noon. Kasi,
yes.
I don't know if you were down that time, pero sabi ko, paano yan? Kaya ba ni Sam this year?
Yeah.
So, when you were appointed to become MGI, that can only be two things eh. Parang either the girl stays the same,
yes.
walang improvement, or everything like works for her. Parang nag-align yung universe, which I think happened to you. Kasi yung transformation mo wasn't drastic naman, pero it was all correct. Like every step. So, ano yung turning point na yun for you? What do you think changed your game?
I think with my experience, new experience every year. Like for example, I tried to be better with myself. I not only in pageantry. Pageantry is just a phase of my life, but it's not the totality of what it is. Like I still focus on my business with my financial advisory. I still do modeling. I'm still active on other things. And that's why also like being in a pageant, sometimes it hindrances me to doing what I can do at the best of the things that I can do, I'm sure. But
girl, always keep your day job.
Yeah, but I'm trying to juggle everything because I know at the end it will be all worth it.
Yeah.
And it will still add value to me if I join or not, or if I win or not. So it will still add to that long-term goal.
Yeah.
So that's why I keep joining.
So, ngayon, kasi yung mga girls will be competing in a pandemic. So, ano yung tips mo sa kanila?
Oh, wow. Have really a support team. Kasi during this time, you cannot do it by yourself.
Yeah.
You really need some cheerleaders, you know, like even yung mga videographers, makeup artists, people who really not just helping you, but really loving you, even if you win or lose. Kasi that's my team.
Yeah.
In 2019, they mourn for me. Parang ganun eh. In 2 weeks, they don't accept jobs. Kasi talagang parang na-depress sila for me. But when they see that I'm already okay and I accepted everything, then that's the time they already moved on.
Yeah.
So doon ko napatunayan na hindi ko bibitawan tong team na to because they really love me.
Yeah. So we know naman na it's more of a challenge to compete in the pandemic. But what is the silver lining naman? Like yung fun part behind it.
The silver lining of all of this is you will have not just a national presence, but also international presence. It's because everything is online.
Yeah.
When I went to MGI, everyone mostly knows me because of Binibini Pilipinas. And that's the mileage that we get from Binibini Pilipinas. And that's what I always keep telling to the girls, tiisin nyo na lang.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you will never appreciate if you're in the moment, but once you conquered it, talagang, doon mo marirealize, wow, ang laki na pala nung impact na nabigay ko and ang laki na pala nung mileage na nakuha ko.
Yeah.
And it can always be helpful for everything that you do after pageant.
Yeah. Ito, personal na ng tanong kasi I don't know if makakapag ano pa tayo, change outfit or anything. Pero, may hapde.
yung una talaga, nung una-una, I'll be honest, yung totoo. Wow, yung totoo.
Girl, wala, gets kita.
Oo, wala talaga. As in, yeah. Wala talaga nung pagka-after ng coronation. As in, wala talaga akong naramdaman. But, after another pageant happened, dun ko na-realize na shucks, parang sayang pala. Kasi parang dun ko na-feel yung importance kung nanalo ko. And dun ko na-realize na whatever happens, I am still in the book of history that yeah. You're the first MGI. Which, di ba dapat ikaw din yun? Which ako, sana, but
winning!
Di ba? But like, masyado ata kitang na-idolize.
Kasalanan ko pala!
Hindi, joke lang naman.
Uh-oh.
No, we know that it's still dependent on the organization. Uh-oh. But you know what I mean? Like, for example, kahit anong sabihin ng ibang tao, you will be part of the history
yeah.
And then you made it. But I know also that we will contribute to that history. And
yeah.
If it wasn't for us, then a next one will never be the first MGI. So that's the beauty of it. And that's why I always say, baka yun talaga yung purpose ko.
Yeah.
It's all about mending all the gaps and, diba?
Which you did so well.
Yeah.
Pero, girl, promise, like, may reason.
May reason
everything for
totoo,
everything.
Naniniwala ako there's higher and greater purpose on all of this and
yeah.
I'm so excited to discover it.
Hindi naman sa kune-question ko kung deserving or not the one who was crowned MGI, but I want to hear it from you because I could see that she's deserving naman. Like, I get why she won. But how about you? Like, why would you say she won? Because
Ooh.
You have more interaction with her. So,
yes.
We have better information from you.
Because I think it's timely and relevant for her to win.
Mm-mm.
Just like, for example, for me, for Stop Asian Hate and for her, Black Lives Matter.
Yeah.
And it's all about the timing.
Yeah.
And aligned to the advocacy of Miss Grand International of Stop the War and Violence.
Yeah.
And in fairness to her, she really worked so hard. She, I think, conquered 3 pageants before coming to MGI.
Yeah.
And she did learn the language for 4
yeah.
months, so that was never easy. And I think I can never do that in 20 days. Bigay na natin yun, talagang hindi ko talaga kaya yun. But more than that, the universe aligned for her. Parang, kumbaga, she joined a lot of pageants
yeah.
and didn't get placed. It was for her.
Mm-mm.
It was for her.
It was her time.
It was her time to grow to that such woman, to be a queen.
Oh, eto, bigyan mo na lang kami ng clues. Kasi there, after your competition, there were a lot of girls who are aiming for the MGI crown already. So, meron ka ba mga napupusuan? And ilan sila? And siguro, some of their traits, like, kung sila yung feeling mong makakuha ng crown, it's because she's black.
Okay. To be honest, you're gonna be MGI if you are a fighter.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I really think. Like, for example, if you will see the girls of MGI, they're all fighters.
Yeah.
Regardless of who they are, what they came from, and then kung ano man yung pinagdaanan nila with Binibining Pilipinas. At the end of their journey, they became stronger. Kasi talagang with MGI, that's the thing that you need to do.
Yeah.
It doesn't really need to be like, ayan na agad. But it molds you now to be that fighter of
yeah.
who you are. And that's gonna be my takeaway also in Binibini and of course with MGI. So whatever happens, dapat fighter siya.
Yeah. So, last question. How has Binibining Pilipinas changed you now that you're
oh
at
God.
The end of your journey?
Wow, alam mo sa totoo lang, parang hindi ko talaga pa siya ma-feel. Na parang I am still in that dreaming side ng nangyayari because I'm still in that process, di ba? Maybe mag-uusap tayo ulit after that,
diba? Sa channel mo naman.
Yeah, pwede. Oh, it was an honor, ganyan. It's gonna be a great privilege. But like, for example, feeling ko, ang saya, and never ko na-imagine na magagawa ko lahat yun.
Mm-hmm.
To be honest, hindi ko talaga in-expect na God will really pave the way for me to do these things. Because when I joined Binibining Pilipinas with Catriona, my dad died.
Yeah.
And that's only my motivation to just do something out of myself and change the way I live.
Mm-mm.
But little did I know that ito pala yung purpose na yun.
Yeah.
And that was very emotional for me because in MGI, I mentioned him, which hindi ko talaga maalala kung ano yung sagot ko na parang...
You mean sa closer interview?
No, yung dun sa coronation night about my dad.
Ah,
like, I had
yeah.
to experience my last of my dad.
Yeah, oo.
And nung kinausap ko si Tito Roj, he was like, ang galing po.
Yeah.
Parang hindi po ikaw.
Super perfect.
Sabi niya, parang sobra daw. Parang nagulat din daw sila na parang may sumanib daw sa akin.
Yeah.
Sabi ko, totoo ba, Tito? Parang ganun. Kasi lagi nilang sinasabi sa akin, na wala na kami problema sa Q&A mo, sa lahat, ganyan. Isa lang. Overthinking. Sabi niya, wag ka na mag-overthink. You just have to let go of everything.
Mm-hmm.
And the moment that I did that, yun yung nangyari.
Yeah.
So, parang, I've been preparing for that moment. Tapos, nag-make sense lahat. Parang, eto na pala yun.
Yeah.
Yun.
Alam mo, sobrang 100 over 100 ka talaga sa akin.
Aww.
After the second question. Kasi sabi ko talaga, may crown na tayo for the
oh
first
my
time.
God.
Pero, congratulations regardless because you have become the turning point in pageantry,
oh,
especially in the pandemic na ang hopeless namin, di ba?
Yeah.
Parang you brought so much joy in so many homes, in so many Filipinos.
Wow.
So, congratulations and maraming salamat na pinaglaban mo ang Pilipinas.
Thank
you
so
made us
much.
Proud.
Thank you so much also. And of course, for all the queens who supported me and maraming salamat sa lahat because I have never gonna do it without also the help of people behind me and the MGI queens from the past. And of course, Kagandahang Flores headed by Tito Rajo. Thank you so much.
Okay, shoot! That's a wrap for our shoot. I hope you enjoyed this episode and please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button so that you won't have to miss an episode.